like you. You seem like a very, very intelligent man.
You're doing this just to kill a guy. You can do whatever wants to be done.
So obviously you're smarter than me, but does that mean you're reserved?
Albert Einstein's IQ was 164.
Hello, everybody. I'm Adam King, the King Source. And today I'm going to talk about the World Baseball Classic. I want to kind of break it down and kind of give my opinion on it. First, subscribe to the channel, especially on Rumble. Helps everybody out. Watch videos always. If you like the videos, really helps everybody out. The stupid new metrics they have on both Rumble and YouTube is just crazy. Please help everybody out. So, with the World Baseball Classic, it has been a success. I would call it a success. But the question is, how big of a success? Well, this year we have seen a lot of injuries. Freddie Freeman is hurt. Probably going to miss the first few weeks of the season. 2 weeks out to the All-Star break with a broken thumb. And then others. It's been interesting. Is it an issue? Then becomes the question. And a couple of pitchers ended up with Tommy John surgery due to pitching in the World Baseball Classic. But I have the feeling that they run spring training and the same injury happens. That's one injury is going to happen no matter what. I really don't think injuries are an issue. Injuries are going to happen anywhere. You can't not play an event this good just because of injury risk. Now, you notice that's an American team in the World Baseball Classic. They won it last year, and they're back in the title game. You don't know who they're playing yet. They'll play the winner of the game tonight. So, it's been a rousing success. It's got more views this year than it ever has. It has not usurped any World Series game yet. The most views any World Baseball Classic game has gotten is 103 million. The World Series games average 132 million per game. Okay? All time, they average about 104 million. TV's really exploded and brought that average up. So it's not true any World Baseball Classic game got more views than any World Series game. Not true at all. The most World Series game got was actually somewhere around 850 million when you counted the, we'll call it posthumous, if I can pronounce that word. That's a word I always struggle with. Post-game views, basically. Posthumous, there's the word. What that means is the views after the game was over and people went back and rewatched it. If we're talking live views, the most was around 255 million. And that was when Hideki Matsui went nuts in Game 7, or no, 6 of the 2009 World Series. Remember, almost all of Japan was viewing that one. And when you calculate that in, you get a huge number. There's 125 million in Japan. It's estimated 80 million in Japan watched that game alone. Plus, you had over 150 million in the U.S. Well over. I think it's over 170 million in the U.S. So, no, that's an out-and-out lie. No World Baseball Classic game has ever out-viewed a World Series game in it. That just hasn't happened. Anyways, looking at it this year, there have been a few things very, very suspicious. U.S. just took out a Venezuela team that had been unbeaten. That's impossible. That's impossible. That's not the way it works. Especially when they're in a group that was absolutely loaded. A pool is what they call it. Not just that, Mexico winning the way they are. Straight up cheating. They're allowed to use players that were not born in Mexico. And the World Baseball Classic rules state that. He uses the word naturalized citizen. It does not just mean becoming a citizen. That means being born in the country. That's what naturalized citizen means. Okay? I could go off on lots of other stuff that I'm not going to for this video. But I do think the World Baseball Classic has been a rousing success and will only grow. It's basically the World Cup of baseball now. But what I do believe they need to rein in is teams illegally using players as Mexico is this year. Like Randy Rosarena, born in the U.S., to a Cuban dad, I believe it is, or something like that, and a Canadian mom or something like that, where he has no claim to Mexico. It's not legal to blame Mexico. He's not the only one. They have five players in their everyday lineup, remember Mexico, that are not legally playing for them. It's illegal for them to even be on that team. This needs to be reined in. They need to enact new rules. So it's going to be interesting to see them do that when they finally do it. There is some concern upon the bosses of the, well, call them the bosses or the execs, basically, of the World Baseball Classic. So, is it a success? Yes. Is it a good enough success to really keep this going? Yes. I do think they need to change a good bit when it's played, maybe move back into February, so it's over before spring training games start. I do think that is a big thing they need to do with the World Baseball Classic. Coverage for it could be done a lot better as well, especially the U.S. games. The parks they play in could have been picked so much better, it's not even funny. They should not be playing in Miami. That's a brain-dead park to be playing in. That's a terrible ballpark. They replaced Pro Player Stadium, the Dolphins Stadium. And I thought they'd make a better ballpark than they did in the renovations they've done to it have been great. It brought the walls in a little bit, made it a lot fairer of a park to hitters, but still it's just not a park you should be doing World Baseball Classic stuff in. It's just not. The other one in Arizona is an okay park, but that center field fence robbed a lot of home runs for the games that were played there. So, yeah. And they have the highest center field fence of any park in baseball, if you didn't know that. That's in Arizona there. I would say it's a success. It doesn't really need to grow anymore. I think it's got max growth. But one thing we need to stop doing is trying to take baseball to the world. It's not a world sport. Baseball is the American sport. We need to keep that in mind. So I like them playing the World Baseball Classic in America because it brings eyes back to America. That said, worldwide teams should be playing the World Baseball Classic. I'm not talking against that. I'm talking against trying to take MLB into other countries, and there's no business playing any MLB games in any country but the U.S. of A. We cannot be using this to try to expand MLB outside the U.S. Mexico wants professional baseball to create their own league. They have one. And the same goes for Japan, Korea, etc. And by the way, I know friends from England. They don't like it. They don't like it. Yeah, they go to it because it's fun to see an American sport, but they don't like baseball. They don't like American sports over there. That's why the European Football League failed so miserably. Okay? That's why the NBA Europe failed. They don't want American sports there. American sports need to stay in America. Straight up. But as far as World Baseball Classic, the format, I think, needs to be fixed. Where you play four games, and then you go right into the quarterfinals. I think it needs to be fixed. Expanded, if you will. Because only 16 countries are allowed in. That does not compare to the other World Cup leagues. Okay. They allow 32 teams in the World Cup for soccer. See the issue there? You have half the teams. So you're losing out on ratings and everything there. That is an issue to me that could be fixed and should be fixed. Now, today's game, pull it back up here, there it is. It's between Mexico and Japan. Two teams have no business being here. Japan is cheating. I have seen the movement that is known for foreign substance abuse from their pitchers, okay? The title game will be, I believe, Tuesday. Yeah, it's Tuesday. U.S. will be playing. That's tomorrow. The other team has no business being here. And, whoa, how did we... Goodness, that's not what we wanted. Let's get back there. There we are. Mexico, again, it's a team of cheating. They have players on that roster. They're not legally on that roster, okay? Roki Sasaki is pitching for Japan. All eyes will be on him. Keep an eye on that one. Japan is another one that they're claiming is undefeated, which is impossible. If they are undefeated, then they're cheating. And, yeah. Mexico does have a loss to Colombia, 5-4. And then they cheated to beat the U.S. 11-5. Japan and the U.S. have not played in this tournament. So it's going to be interesting to see how that one turns out. But, plain and simple, why are teams being allowed to use players that are not legally on there? Why is Japan being allowed to cheat with their pitching? Because the World Baseball Classic uses the MLB ball. When you are good at pitching in Japan, which has a smaller ball, closer to a Little League-sized ball, you can't just grab an MLB ball and adjust it to our pitching well. It's just not possible. You have to have months, if not a year, to adjust. Very fishy that the Japanese are doing that. The Mexico League, they do use a baseball the same size, basically, as the U.S. ball. It is smaller, but it's such an incremental difference. It's not going to throw them off. Most of the other leagues that way. Korea uses the Japan ball. So it is very, very fishy. I think the World Baseball Classic is a success. I'm going to straight up say it is a success, but they do need to edit it. I think double the teams. Go up to 32 countries allowed in it. Then you can have 8 per pool. Let them battle it out for 5-6 games. And then the top 16 advance, say. You have 4 pools of 8 and the top 4 advance into around a 30 or 16. Excuse me. Yeah, it would be around a 16. Expand it. That's a problem with MLB as well. They haven't had enough teams in the postseason. Now that they've gone to 7-8 side, baseball's become a lot more competitive. A lot more competitive. Another thing I've noticed with this World Baseball Classic is players that are playing for the right country, but that are playing beyond their capabilities, beyond their means. It's a little bit fishy, but Trey Turner is a big one. He's not known for power, yet he is hitting the cover off the ball. One home run after another. Highly, highly suspicious there. So, I would keep doing the World Baseball Classic, and I like it on this every 3 to 4 year thing, but I do think they need some tweaks, some changes, and force proper players and proper teams. Expand it, etc. But the Kings are breaking down the World Baseball Classic. I do expect the U.S. to win the championship tomorrow. Have a great day, everybody. Remember, the KingSource loves you.